As head of this family, we must put to rest this issue of marriage between Obijofo and Olamma.
Good. It's high time we took a stand on it.
We have looked forward to a marriage between the two royal families. But as things stand now, it is an illusion.
An illusion? How, Your Majesty?
One of our cardinal duties as parents is to guide these children. I believe that Olama is old enough to make her choice of a marriage partner. Since she does not want Obijofor, we must put that issue to rest and let her be.
Certain experiences have made me to see reasons with what Father is saying. And what I'm looking at right now is how Ola is going to make good use of this opportunity we're giving her now. Because I'm going to have a very high expectation of whoever she's going to get married to.
What are you saying? Your Majesty, Ikenna, are you saying we should allow her not to marry Obijofor just because she's looking for a perfect man? Olamo, where are you going to see that perfect man?
Mom, I know that there are no perfect men out there. But I also know that you married a near-perfect man. Right?
Who are you asking? My friend, say whatever you want to say.
What I'm trying to say is that it cannot work out between Obijofor and I. I need to find a man that will take care of me, just like Father has always taken care of you. Once I can find that man, I'll be ready for marriage.
What was that for?
Your Majesty, I don't know what's wrong with her.
How can you tell me that you don't know what is wrong with her? Your friend walked in here, saw you, looked at you, sighed at you, and left without greeting you. And you did not even greet her. And you're telling me nothing is wrong. Ujunwa!
Yes, Your Majesty.
Where is Ujunwa?
Let me call her, Your Majesty.
I'm happy it's settled. Olamma can now go ahead and marry whoever she wants to marry.
Come.
Good day, Your Highness. Aunt Choma, Princess Olamma wants to see you.
Where is she?
She's in front of the palace.
Tell her I'll be right there. Please, go to the kitchen and tell them to be fast with the food I asked them to prepare. Ikenna, let me go and see Olamma.
It's alright. But don't stay too long, don't stay too long.
I will not.
I came for us to discuss about the wedding plans.
Whose wedding?
Ours, of course.
Carlo, please don't make me laugh. I told you I wasn't ready for marriage. Please, I need time to think about this whole thing.
Oh, Ijoma, why are you sounding like this? Eh? What is there to think about? I love you as much as you love me. So So what is the problem?
Patience. Carly, you need to be patient with me. Please. Marriage is not what we can just rush into.
Hey, wifey.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I hope I didn't disturb you from what you were doing.
Not at all. What's going on?
Listen, I had already made up my mind about something, but I'm beginning to have doubts. I would like you to accompany me somewhere, please.
Oh, God. But I'm not dressed. By the way, where is this you want us to go to?
Listen, I cannot explain to you right now. We need to leave here before Ujunwa comes out.
Ujunwa? Why Uju?
My mom asked Ujunwa to follow me everywhere and know every of my movements.
Really?
Yes.
How do we go then?
I cannot explain to you right now. Are you coming with me or not? Please, I need to go. I need to be sure of something.
Okay, just hold on. Let me get my car so we could go with my car.
How do we go? Are we going to trek?
Okay, just get your car. Let me go down out there.
Okay, just hold on.
Your Majesty, you sent for me.
Yes, I did. Where is Olamma?
Your Majesty, I don't know where she went to.
Go and look for her. When you see her, tell her that I want to see her here.
Okay, Your Majesty.
Is there something you're not telling me?
Your Majesty, that's why I came in the first place. I am quarreling with Olamma because I told her the truth about the man she's dating now.
The man she's dating now?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Who is that?
My taxi driver that drives me around.
What? Your taxi driver wants to marry my daughter?
Your Majesty, I didn't say they're getting married. I just don't know what they're doing.
How possible is that?
Here. It's like you two know each other.
Yes, Emenike and I went to the same university.
Really?
He was one of the most brilliant senior students. And whenever we have problems, we'll go to him to help us out. Emenike, is this you?
Wow. But I hope there's nothing else apart from me.
List of it, Princess. Chioma. So that time was one of the... She was a child. Yes, I mean, if I check very well, I'm sure you were one of the youngest in your department.
Please, I beg you. Enough.
I'm right, am I not?
Anyway, okay, enough. Enough of all the old time stories. Because if I let you guys continue like this, we won't live here today. I mean, okay, you've seen how. This is my brother's wife.
Are you for real?
Yes.
Oh, my pleasure. Nice meeting you.
You know, I've been like pleading with her to come see you so she can meet the great MNK I talk about all the time. Lo and behold, you both know each other.
Small world.
Small world. She's been saying so much about you, and I never knew you're the same MNK she's been talking about.
Hi, my dear.
Nice to meet you once more.
Same here again.
But let me warn you, the small Chioma you used to know those days is now a big girl. Don't you ever try to break her heart. Because if you do, I will kill you with my bare hands. I promise you.
Did you hear that?
I'm
very scared now.
What is your problem? tell me what happened.
Mother, what is it?
Talk to me. I'm here now.
Olamma has finished me. I don't know what I did to deserve this.
You should accept the fact that we are done with this thing. Allow her be.
Mother, why are you bothering yourself over this issue again? Why?
It's okay. I will not trouble myself again. I will let it be. For when you will know how stubborn I can be, is when one of you kicks against the jobless taxi driver that Olamma wants to marry now.
What did you say?
Mother, what did you just say?
I think we should let it be. We should not trouble ourselves again.
A man does not fight with two hands when he is after what does not belong to him. Mm-hmm. You know, you came from the bloodline of warriors. Your great grandfathers never lost any battle, but sometimes, in pursuit of self-preservation, it is the perceived weak that stands in their homes to point at the uninhabited homes of the brave.
Yes, Adivia. It is true that the bride price paid on a man's mother's head amounts to nothing when proverbs are explained to him. But don't you think you have to be more specific in pointing out these frogs in the heap of stones, because their shapes have little or no difference?
Igwe, tell your son that a man does not fight with two hands for that which does not belong to him. That's why I'm here.
Princess, I'm not in doubt over your feelings for me. But I just want you to understand who I am, Emenike. In between two big royal ships, what if they capsize on me? What will happen to me? I want you to also see this journey not as just nobody, but as people who are educated and informed. That this is not a journey that should be toyed around with, but a journey that is very dangerous, if you allow me to say. All I want to know is, will you be there for me all the way?
Yeah. You're very correct. But I want you to know that there is nothing to fear. Nothing will happen to you. Listen, I've grown to love you. I've grown to be so fond of you that I always want to be around you.
I understand.
Don't you see how we play? How we talk? How we reason? That's all I want. When I'm with you, I don't feel like leaving your side. I'm satisfied. That is what I want in life. I want happiness. I want to be able to have this bond with my man. And I have that bond with you. I love you. I love you, and I will always stand by you all the way. I'm not turning back.
I know. I understand. But look at it another way. Who is Emenike, by the way? A taxi driver who do not even have a vehicle right now to work with. Just me and my mom. In our poor world,
you a princess. Have you thought about it? That you'll get pregnant tomorrow. We need to go to the hospital. You will need clothes, you need cosmetics, you need jewelry. How will I meet up with all those demands? I will be heartbroken if you walk around and people push their nose to you and say, look at her now. How would we do that?
I'm happy you talk this way. Which is why I believe in you. Because you are a real man. You have the intelligence. You have the focus. You have the strength. You have the wisdom. The only thing you lack is the means, which is riches and wealth. The Holy Book says that he who finds a good wife finds a good thing and obtaineth favor from the Lord. What else do you want? Listen, all we should ask God for right now is long life and good health. Once we have that, money, riches, wealth, which you need to be the great man you should be, is not a problem and will not be a problem. It will come.
For me to go out with your own sister?
That's not what I meant.
Then what is it? I should stop talking to her? Or you mean I shouldn't go out with her again? Let me understand it.
I don't know what you're talking about. I asked a simple question and I demand...
And I've answered you the way I understood it.
Chioma, we all agreed that Olamma should be allowed to marry whoever she wants to marry because she doesn't want Obijofo anymore. But getting to know that it is all because of one jobless fellow is something I cannot live with.
Ikenna. Ikenna.
Where did she take you to?
Mom. The truth is that I am an adult. If I commit any crime today, no matter how much you love me, you will not go to jail for me. I am responsible for my own decisions and actions. The only thing I owe you as my mother is to respect and listen to your advice.
Olamma, it is not just listening to my advice. It is putting it into action.
Mom, I have my own rights.
Olamma, do not force me to lock you up in this palace. You know I'm capable of doing it.
Then I'll start considering getting my own place in town and living on my own. Father.
What is this I hear about you and an ordinary taxi driver?
Just dance to our tune, okay?
But who? Do you know why I brought you here? I brought you here so you can feel pain and humiliation. Oh yeah. Shut up, I'm still talking. And I decided to do this in front of everybody here because you are nobody. Oh yeah. And so my boys will beat you, flog you, do anything they like to you. They can even kill you and nothing will happen. You know why? Because I am in charge. Proceed.
Flog him. Now dance to our tune.
Your Majesty, I greet you.
Chioma.
Your Majesty, there's something I want us to discuss.
Okay, sit down.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
What is it?
Your Majesty, please permit me to speak freely.
Go ahead.
Fire is such a beautiful thing. It either brings joy or pain, depending on the usage.
I don't understand what you're saying.
Nobody is happy that Olamma left Obijofor, who seems to have everything. But I know you can still do something as a mother.
Chioma. I still cannot get your drift.
As long as Olamma sees it that everybody is against her, she will not be able to open up her mind and tell us her reasons. She might have good reasons. I know as a good mother, you want the best for her. If she goes there tomorrow and something goes wrong, you will also feel her pains.
Chioma, does this discussion have anything to do with the taxi driver?
Your Majesty,
nobody.
Yeah, no one.
Well, I've known the place. It's all right. Let's go. I will come and check later.
Okay.
Let's go.
Emenike. Emenike, what happened to you? Emenike. What? Are you all right? What happened?
Is this the person we came to see?
Emenike! Sit. Are you alright? What happened to you? Where are you coming from?
I went to see the taxi driver. I just went to have a chat. But he was not home. On my way out, I saw him walking. He barely managed to walk in. He was battered and assaulted.
Battered? By who?
I don't know whether to tell you that he had an accident or that the devil himself sent people that beat him up. I couldn't even make out his face.
Why? Why would they beat him up?
I wouldn't know.
Oh my God.
So, did you take him to the hospital?
What's the problem?
Chigemezu, you haven't slept? You're meant to be sleeping by now. Go and sleep.
Sister, you have been like this since you came back this evening. What's the problem?
There's no problem, okay? I'm fine. Just go back to bed. Go on. Go. We could have done was to take him to the hospital. What if he dies? Why did I even listen to Ikenna? God. God is going to judge me. Oh, God.
Is in danger. Emenike, how? How did you know? Ikenna told me that he went to his house to discuss with him.
Oh my God! Did Ikenna hurt him?
No! Ikenna didn't do anything to him. When he got to his house, Emenike wasn't there. On his way out, Emenike staggered in with bruises all over his face.
Oh my God. Oh no, no, no. What do I do now?
Oh, what are you trying to do?
I have to go.
It's already late. Tomorrow morning you can't go and see him. Please.
See, I can't wait till morning.
Please, don't get me in trouble. You can't even know I came to tell you. Relax. Just calm down. Calm down.
Abi Jafar.
Yes, Father.
Eze Dibia was here earlier today. And from what I gathered from all he said, he is advising that you take off your hands from the fight for Olama's hands in marriage.
Really?
Yes.
Father, was he not the same person who visited Elephantiasis upon Ezoke because he felt insulted by Ezoke's utterances? Was he not?
Yes, he is.
Now he wants me to forgive those who have insulted me. Father, tell Ezedibia to stay clear before I visit the same Elephantiasis upon him.
Obi, it is true that you are from a bloodline of warriors, yes. But a warrior without good head is that warrior that is never celebrated alive by his people.
Oh, I don't need anybody to celebrate me. I don't need anybody to celebrate me, Father. All I need is for them to feel my pain. And I will do more. And as for Ezedibia,
where did you go to? You just left without telling me.
I went to quickly confirm something from Ola.
A
about what I just told you?
No, not at all. I went to discuss girls' things with her. You wouldn't understand.
Really?
Yeah. No. It's not what you think. Like, as I said, we went to discuss girls' things.
All right. It's all right. You just went to discuss girls' things, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We're going to the bedroom now to discuss boys' things.
Things
you would love to hear. You don't want to discuss that.
Oh my God, you're such a naughty boy.
No, you love it or not, you enjoy it too.
Sorry.
Hey.
Sorry, my son.
Hey.
Princess, what are you doing out here this late?
Listen, I am going out right now. Just go and open that gate for me now.
But Princess, you know there is no way we can allow you to walk out alone this night.
Exactly. And who says I am walking? I am driving and you are coming with me.
Me?
Listen, in case they happen to find out that I am not around, don't say anything. You don't know anything until I am back. Am I understood?
Yes, Your Highness.
You hear? Take this key. Go to where the car is. Don't start it. Just roll it. Roll it till you roll it out of the gate. Then we can start it. Be fast.
But Princess, what if they notice your absence in this palace? What do you want me to say?
Are you dumb? Told you that in case they ask of me or they notice my absence, just tell them you don't know. You don't know. Dump.
See, what's the problem?
Sorry.
God! Emenike, who did this to you? Mama, who did this to him?
I don't know, my daughter. I don't know what my son has done to deserve this.
Has he taken any medication?
I just finished dabbing him with hot water. I was rubbing him up my way he came.
No, he has to go to the hospital. Uba, please help me. Drop the salt, please.
I am certain you did not tell your father that they are coming to this place. I am sure he would have told you that a ram that wants to butt heads with another ram will first of all consider seriously the strength of his neck.
Well, that is total bullshit, Ezedibia. I just want to warn you, stay clear of my case, or I will be forced to take care of you the way I take care of my problems.
Let me assume that you are drunk.
Ezedibia, do not make yourself my problem.
Not that people, they ask, when did Ezedibia start molesting and abusing children? I would have made you exchange blows with the wind around your head. And I'm sure that will cure every madness that is pushing you around.
What is it?
I should be asking you what the problem is. What is it?
I'm asking you.
And where are you taking that to?
Your Majesty, the king said he would like to have some at breakfast.
Okay. Go and give it to him. Then tell Olamma that she should come to the dining immediately.
Okay, Your Majesty.
Where are you going?
I just want to send one of the guards on an errand.
Oh. Okay. Remember, breakfast is served.
I know, I'll be there.
Good morning, Your Highness.
Good morning. Which of you knows Ebele's house?
Your Highness, it should be Oba.
Are you sure?
Yes, Your Highness. He was one that directed Prince Obijofo to the house some time ago.
Get him from me.
Since morning, I've not seen him. He was on night duty with Tabo. And when I came to change over, I saw Tabo. I didn't see him.
Find him and bring him to me.
Fast.
Where is Olamma?
I sent Ujumwa to call her. I'm surprised she's still not here.
Majesty.
Ujumwa, I sent you to call Olamma for me. Where is she?
Your Majesty, I've been knocking on her door since, but she didn't answer me.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
You were the guard on duty last night?
Yes, Your Majesty. With who were you on duty?
Where is my daughter?
Your Majesty, I...
Everybody's talking about our love. They said it shouldn't be. Said you were not meant for me, but every time I close my eyes, I see you.
Sorry, you'll be fine.
My daughter, thank you very much. It's only God that will reward you for this kindness. Thank you.
Amen.
Princess.
Don't call me princess. I know I am the princess, but please just call me Olamma.
Olamma. Thank you very much. God bless you.
God bless you too. I've given Mama money. In case there's anything you want, she can buy with it. I'll be back to check on you later. Mama, I have to go. You know it's been long I left the palace, so they don't start looking for me. Please take care of yourself, honey.
Thank you very much, my daughter. Bye.
Bye-bye.
It's good to be successful in life. Did you see how Princess was ordering the doctor and the nurses around?
Mama. I thank God. I thank God that she was here for me. She would take me to the hospital, Mama. How would I have survived? The pains and everything.
It's okay, my son. It's okay. I thank God for Princess.
Your Majesty, the princess said that I shouldn't tell anybody of her whereabouts until she returns.
Majesty?
Yes, Your Majesty.
So, I'm going to kill you, bury you in a shallow grave and wait for Lama to come back. You can now.
Father.
Go get my gun.
Please, Your Majesty. I'm begging Your Majesty, please forgive me. Forgive me. It was Oba. Yes, it was Oba that she went out with. It was last night, late in the night. Yes, Your Majesty. Please forgive me.
Where is she?
Honestly, Your Majesty, I don't know. I don't know, Your Majesty. Please forgive me.
So you expect me to keep you alive after all this? I will keep you alive after all this.
Chigozie! Chigozie!
Everybody's talking about our love. They said it shouldn't be. They said you were not meant for me. But every time I close my eyes, I see you. Every day and night, I'm thinking of you. Your love has got me crazy. Nothing in the world can stop me. For